Hi, Mom. Yeah, no, can you pick up Chris after school? Yeah, I'm at the doctor's.
Mrs. Harris?
Describe your symptoms.
Hang on. Stress, headaches, nausea. Well, I work on Saturdays.
And how long has this been?
Equanimity. Balance your lifestyle.
Well, I am at Ford's World Headquarters. They had their annual trend conference and invited me along for the ride, so to speak. And I've gotten to take a real sneak peek under the hood of a lot of the innovation that's coming out. You know, what's going to shape the future of what mobility and transportation looks like in America over the next several years. So one of those huge trends is sustainability. I have in my hands this leftover agave, shredded agave husk. Now, agave is the main ingredient in tequila. So every single year, there's about 700,000 pounds of this husk left over. Ford's taking that, creating a bioplastic out of it, and that bioplastic is then replacing petroleum-based plastic in the cars. Now, here's something I had no idea. About 400 pounds of petroleum-based plastic is in just about every single car in America. Swap that out for something sustainable, cuts down on the car's weight, cuts down on emission, gas use, and all of that means that it cuts down on how much money we're spending, not only for the cars, but in driving and maintaining the cars. So it's a win-win all the way around. And Ford's looking at other things like shredded money to turn into different things, various jeans material. They're even taking foam from soybeans and turning those into seats. They're already using those in seats in all of their vehicles.
That's very exciting. I want my audience to remember that. I told you I would be speaking with Jennifer Jolly. She's the award-winning consumer tech journalist, and you can hear the excitement in her voice. You're live. We do. We hear it. You're live there in Dearborn, Michigan, from the fourth annual Trend Conference. These are great innovations, Jennifer.
Yeah, you know, I'm a jaded journalist. I've been doing this about 20 years, and I am naturally enthusiastic, but it's hard to impress me. One of the other really cool things I've seen and done here is gone for a test drive in Ford's fully autonomous vehicle. It's still a prototype at this stage, I really should say the car took me for a drive, not the other way around. It's a Ford Fusion prototype Class 4 fully autonomous vehicle. Now, it still has a few parts on it, like a steering wheel. Well, in a few years it won't. So the steering wheel's going away, the gas pedal's going away, the gears are going away, the brakes going away, the driver's going away. I rode in one of these yesterday. I can't tell you how weird it is that this car is going down the road. I went around lunchtime. People are coming out, you know, all over the place to walk to lunch. It's a beautiful day in Dearborn, and all I'm thinking is, please don't run them over, please don't run them over, please don't run them over. It stops every single time where it's supposed to. So of course I kept thinking, you know, how does this work? Well, on top of the cars, there's a LIDAR. It's a light sensitive radar that acts as the car's eyes, ears, skin, you know, the car's senses, so to speak. There's a grid, an array of cameras that are also picking up and processing information. All of that's going through a supercomputer that can process that information just thousands of times really faster than our own brains can. So that's really how the technology is working. We will see these cars on the road, Ford says, within 4.5 years, first as ride-sharing cars in urban areas to ease the gridlock issues so many of us are having. And I would think after that, and this is just what I think, is that not too long after that, we'll be seeing them as personal vehicles as well.
This is truly evolution that we're in. We're in a technology evolution. Yeah.
It's evolutionary, it's revolutionary, and it's really Jetson's magic.
It is. It really is. So, got any more trends that we're going to be seeing in the future at here in Dearborn, Michigan?
Absolutely. Expect to see your wearables, your smart watches and even your smartphones continue to get smarter and take care of little issues that you might have in a vehicle. For instance, before you get in the car, it'll feel that it'll know that you're around, either with some kind of Bluetooth technology or some other similar technology that will sense your presence and make the car the exact right temperature for you. Turn on your radio station. Wearables eventually will come to a place where the wearable senses your heart rate. The car will know long before you do when you're getting too tired to drive, or say if you're having a heart attack or a stroke. So just expect things to get smarter and this technology just to keep impressing us. It's amazing.
It is. It's dazzling. I just broke my phone, and Gmail had backed up everything for me. So no one knows that, I was out of commission. I love it. There's never been a better time than now.
Absolutely.
Jennifer Jolly, where would you send my audience on the web so that they can see these magnificent creations?
I'm going to post all my insider's view of everything I've seen here at jenniferjolly.com.
All right, Jennifer, you keep being enthusiastic. I've seen you on Dr. Oz, I've seen you on CNN, but you're my best when you're on the Valder Beebe Show. Thank you.
I love it. Thank you so much.